Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds, Peril on Gorgon. I am Amethyst Lunatari, finally heading to meet Jasper Low, or at least attempt to locate him at the Olympus Orbital Pharmaceutical Station, I believe it's called? Yeah. Somewhere by Olympus, which you never could go before. And you know what? I'm wondering if the next DLC will take place on Hephaestus. I've been wanting to check out the mines over there. Very familiar with Monarch, yeah. Tartarus, you know. Typhon. Yeah, we've got some other places to go. I mean, these are gas giants, so. But still.
We've arrived at the Olympus Orbital Pharmaceutical Station.
Can we get a look at Olympus? Oh, cool. I was gonna get stuck there. Alright, awesome. Hope there's a, what do you call it? A vending machine here we can avail ourselves of. Let's see if we can meet up with Jasper Low.
Keep my head down.
Well, we've got at least two hostiles. Three, actually. Done. Landed. Jasper Low is somewhere on the station. Find Dr. Low. Or whatever's left of him. So we're finding him to get, access to the CHEM Lab on Gorgon. A couple episodes ago, we got access to the HIA facility from, what's her name again? I can't remember this poor lady's name. Actually, she's probably, she's responsible for, or at least partially responsible for creating the Marauders, apparently. Dr. Marion Blakesley. So we've got access to that building. So figure before we head back to Gorgon, get access to as much as we can. Okay, already a dead body. Weapons at the ready. Yes, we've got a vending machine.
Another science lab, another dead body. How refreshing.
Is it, though? We have a lot of stuff to get unload here. All these toss ball sticks we were invaded. Last episode. By a former toss ball team turned pirates? Scavengers? I'm not sure. I already have a grenade launcher, don't I? Yeah, this one? Yeah. I picked up a lot of crap. So if you press E twice, it just sells them both? Oh, good to know. I'm always clicking the accept. There you go. Gonna be hard to change that habit. Oh, I should just keep one of each just to keep the weight down, but our options open. What we got? That's better. I'm a lot less weighed down now. And immediately picking up more crap.
Great work.
Why, thank you. Total access. Welcome, K. Morine. Reception log. Log entry date ranges. Day 001 to 110. Olympus Orbital Pharmaceutical Station. Property of Anti-Cleo. As per my required duties, I am keeping a visitor's log. Day 001, 2, 3, no visitors. Day 061, sometimes we experience long power outages. Sitting in the dark, listening to the storm beat at the walls, I've got a lot of time to think. It begs to be let in, while I would pay to be let out. Day 108, no visitors. Day 109, still no visitors. Day 111 to 150. Day 115. Why are there a bunch of tailless sprats running about? This facility doesn't have a sprat catcher on the roster. Maybe I should file a request with acquisitions for one. Teacup canids are famed for their ability to hunt sprats after all, and for keeping people company. Day 116, no visitors. Day 117, no visitors. Can't finish my game of solitaire. Someone stole a handful of cards from the deck. Day 118, desk unmanned. Unsuccessfully hunted for the missing cards. Day 51, 151 to 250. Day 157, canid request was denied. Day 158, we've run out of caffeinoid. Our first restocking shipment isn't set to arrive until the new fiscal year, quote-unquote. I guess that delivery will mark the facility's first visitors. Now there's something to look forward to. Day 159, did some digging in the system records. It turns out our supplies are set to be delivered by, get this, a crew of automechanicals. So you're not even going to have human visitors. Day 182, thought I heard knocking on the front door, but it turned out to be just some thunder. Always thunder. Funny how it can sound like so many different things. A boom, a crack, a snap, knocking, laughing, screams. Oh boy. Day 251 to present. Day 277, I've started venturing outside. At first, I worried something fierce about all the lightning strikes. Sometimes the electromechanical turbine goes on the fritz without warning. But I'm out of cards and out of caffeinoid, and there's not much else to do. Day 301, turns out I no longer need to feel safe. What I need is to feel alive. Outside, the wind howls like a raging god, and the rain stabs into my throat like a thousand tiny frozen needles. And in that pain, well, I feel so very alive. Outside. Surely she doesn't, like, try to step foot on a planet? Because she walks around outside. But how is there even an atmosphere? Walking around outside the station. Day 3322. My many and varied attempts to trigger an on-site inspection from the Special Committee for Auditing and Management have failed. Day 353. Sometimes when I look over the ledge, I think about what it would feel like. How easy it would be to simply tip forward, to plummet, with all those clouds kissing my face, to fall away from the storm, to smile, then break. Okay. Is that what happened to this person? She just, like, decided to, like, fall into a gas giant?
Auntie's going to take care of you. It'll be okay.
Beg your pardon?
Everything's going to be okay. Just breathe, Kelly. Everything's going to be all right.
Open the door. I can hear you breathing, you little lab sprat.
Who's out there?
You've got to the count of three to open up, or I'm bashing this door in. Is that the receptionist?
Yates? Is that you? Find your own damn hiding place.
One.
You think I'll cave to the demands of a madwoman?
Two.
Now, just hold on a minute. There's no need to get violent.
Three.
Wait, wait! I'm opening the door, I swear.
It's you. You're still alive.
Let me just catch my breath. I swear, my heart's trying to punch its way out of my chest.
That's like aliens.
Wow. I've got to say, you're even scarier looking than I thought you'd be. Just don't hurt me. I'll cooperate.
I've got questions, and I'm in a hurry.
And I'm in a hurry to get out of here, so I'll answer any way I can.
Who are you?
I'm Kelly Marine, the receptionist. And before you ask, I wasn't manning the visitor's desk when the mechanicals went haywire, because no one comes here.
Hmm.
Not ever. Not since all us station workers were dropped off at the start of the project a year ago.
Why are you working as a receptionist if no one ever comes here?
You're an odd one, aren't you? No respectable company operates without a receptionist.
Well, who do you receive?
Projects on a yearly rotation cycle. Once a year, Anti-Clear reviews our work and decides if we get more rations, personnel, deadlines, that sort of thing. At first, I thought it was an honor, getting assigned to a lab up in the ether high above Olympus. But I didn't know what it'd be like, day in and day out.
I'm guessing it was boring.
Cabin fever sets in at about 90 days. Anti-Cleo's official term is contagious irritable claustrophobia, and it ain't covered by the company's medical policy.
Nothing to do about it?
Nothing good if the last year's taught me anything. Isolation like this is supposed to strengthen bonds between workers, isn't it? All I ended up as was the butt of a bunch of jokes. But enough about me. I never did ask why you were here.
I'm looking for Dr. Jasper Low.
If I had to guess, you'd probably find his body either in his office or the labs. Or heck, he could have been on the toilet. I don't know.
His body.
No bones about it, he was the smartest of us all. Maybe he evaded the automechs, too.
Hmm. So I might find his body, but he might be alive. Anything else you can tell me before I go?
Like what?
Why is everyone dead?
Pink slip protocol.
That was my nickname and traits. The company decided to terminate the team. Why?
How should I know? I just monitor the front desk. Well, except for the last couple of days when I've been hiding out in here. If you work at Oops, you're doing research and development. If we're not researching or developing fast enough, the protocol's there to put the fear in us. Somebody messed up. When one of us makes a mistake, the whole facility pays for it. I know it sounds harsh, but it was in our contracts and everything.
Wait, it is called Oops. Olympus Orbital Pharmaceutical Station. This place is called Oops?
Yep. Olympus Orbital Pharmaceutical Station. Anti-Cleo's naming and branding department's the best in Halcyon.
I'm not agreeing, but what's the purpose of this facility? What were you making?
I'm not making anything. The research team, they were brewing up some improvement to Anti-Cleo's anthracillin.
That's what I meant.
Science stuff isn't really my area, though, so I don't know more than that.
Well, I've got a ship. Do you need a lift out of here?
Do I ever?
Sweet.
Drop me off in the groundbreaker and I'll be out of your hair in no time.
All right, go ahead.
Oh, thank you so much. I'll just hide in a crate or something. You won't even know I was there.
You don't need to hide in
here,
a crate.
This is my official laboratory headgear. I won't be needing it anymore, so it's all yours.
Thanks, I guess. Alright, so we're gonna drop her off on the groundbreaker. Huh. That's interesting. Gotta say, I'm enjoying this content a lot more than the actual, you know...
I'll keep quiet.
Gorgon stuff. Well, I don't think we need to sneak right now. Goes up. Well, she had food. Somewhat to help her hold out. And drink. Olympus Orbital Station key card. Oh, looks like a storage area.
Handled beautifully.
And more sprats. Alright, it's the kitchen, obviously. Immediately pick up this stuff and sell it all. Don't normally find a locked locker. Oh, look. Little passage. I see him down there. No, I let him out. Look at that. At least she... At least she didn't actually, step foot and drop off into a gas giant. Cell stability mono lens, like a microscope, but strapped to your face. Good for seeing things you really wish you hadn't. Bonus to extra headshot weak spot damage. Well, it's so low compared to everything else. Sold. So much crap. Alright, so... Yeah, should I really... This doesn't really matter.
I'm not getting through.
I like that. You see that one shot? It ricocheted off the banister. That was pretty cool. There's something else that way. Another dead scientist. So the automechanicals came in and killed the scientists because they weren't bringing in the results that they wanted. I love these corporations, don't you? Some real humanitarians. This goes up. Where? Oh, I hear that one. Jasper Low. He's that way, but we're gonna look around. Oh, the humanity. Oh, there's... Now there's... two or three of those things. Through here, I guess? Let me just make sure I got everything here. Sounds like an alarm. Just a bathroom? Oh.
Impressive as always.
Oh, you guys. Shucks, you guys. Have you been up here? Yes, we have. Alright, so where are these other automechanicals then? Does that mean they're just upstairs? It definitely looks like up on a higher level. Caught sight of them for a second. Because there's just nothing this way. Oh. And this... Okay. Electromechanical turbine platform. And station laboratory. Alright. Ready for anything.
Try not to think about the structural integrity of this place. Perhaps I shouldn't have mentioned anything.
Hopefully we get off of here relatively quickly. Okay, what's down there? This is where it came from? Oh. Not sure what's down there. Let's see. I don't know if this is where he came from, or just... Oh, it's a small area. Okay. Separate area from where we've been. The dead scientist. That calls the elevator, right? Yeah. Easily we can shoot through the rails like that. The terminal over there. Tough.
New incoming, Captain.
They're tough. And they're fast. Lab is closed up. Told you they were tough. All lined up. Wow. So many dead scientists. And for what?
Wow.
What'd I tell you? What? It's dark over here. Another vending machine, yeah, I guess we'll use it. After we finish looking around here. Before we go in there, let's just finish looking around down here. I'm sure there's more stuff. There's always more stuff. Nothing here to see. Oops. Guess we haven't even checked out that terminal yet. Adrena time. So many things.
That was quick.
So many things. Now here we've been up. don't know what this is. A map of the system? Looks like the entire galaxy there. Orbiting a black hole. I'll be right with that. Oh, a little area. A storm cannon? Ooh. That sounds pretty interesting. Dr. Low's Sky High Mix.
Huh. Oh, clever.
It's old hat by now, dear. Old hat. Blood. Is that Dr. Low's blood? That's Storm Cannon. Forged from materials found in the atmosphere of Olympus. Not recommended for use by anyone suffering from lightning-related trauma. Well. Okay. And then we picked up Dr. Low's Sky High Mix. A small dose of a highly potent caffeinoid. It will reduce the cost of actions during tactical time dilation by 80% for the duration. Actions minus 18%. 15 seconds. Keep away from small children unless they're having trouble concentrating on their homework. Gotta love it. Wow. Is this, like, open? No, that's a... This one, let's see if we can jump there. Alright, this terminal here.